Hello everybody and welcome back to another video of DrER.tv. My name is Dr. Carlo Ojeda. I'm an emergency physician in this channel and I post medical education videos mostly and some family, some personal stuff. I had a lot of concerned subscribers emailing me directly asking me, where are you? What's going on? We haven't seen any videos from you. And the truth is I do have some video footage that I just haven't sat down to edit and post, but I do have some procedure videos coming up, so stay tuned for those. And I don't want my videos to be the same stuff over and over again. I wanna have something to say. And I do have something to say today, so I decided to go ahead and make this video and go ahead and post it. So the first thing is that what I'm gonna say in this video are my personal opinions and by no means is evidence-based medicine or literature or my physician recommendations for your own decisions on medical health, just my perspective of different things and what I'm gonna do in regards to my own health. So the issue came up that they are going around the hospital giving staff personnel the flu shot. And normally every year, the most of the reason I get my flu shot every year is because I don't wanna have to wear a mask. The hospital, in order to protect our patients and other staff members, requires us to take our flu shot. That way, one, less chance of you getting the flu. Second, if you do get the flu, the less likely you'll be sick, the less likely you'll be able to transmit the disease. And if you do end up getting sick or hospitalized, the days that you're sick or the severity of the illness tends to be much lower. So those are the arguments towards getting the flu shot. But I am healthy. I don't have diabetes, pulmonary disease, asthma. I don't smoke. I walk when I golf, those kinds of things. So I don't really want to take the flu shot normally. But every year, my excuse has been, if I don't take the shot, then I'm forced to wear a mask during the whole flu season. And I don't want to do that. Except this year, I'm wearing a mask. Everyone's wearing a mask. We have to wear the mask all the time. So the question is, should I get the flu shot this year? And honestly, I don't think we're gonna see a lot of flu this year. I think we're gonna see it. Obviously, flu doesn't go away. It just doesn't get very infective until certain seasons, right? So I think this year, our flu season is gonna be very limited. Why? Because most people are wearing masks. Kids are getting temperature screens. When you go to certain places, you get temperature screens. If you have any kind of illness, people are much more aware of that, and they're definitely avoiding being close to people. There's so much more acceptance of you not showing up work because you feel under the weather. So I think all of that is gonna limit flu transmission as well as coronavirus transmission. So I don't think we're gonna have a flu season, not like it's been in other years. Because we're all taking the measures to prevent coronavirus transmission, which are the same kind of precautions as the flu. Now, they're not the same disease, and one does not protect for the other, but they're both airborne transmission, upper respiratory infections, so I think we're gonna be okay for the flu. Having said that is, you know, obviously you don't wanna get the flu and coronavirus, you know, so if there's something you can prevent, or you can diminish the likelihood of being severely ill, you should do that. But there is comments, there is rumors that maybe we'll have a coronavirus vaccine released to healthcare workers and first responders by November this year. And the question is, will I take the vaccine? So if I'm not taking the flu, will I take the coronavirus vaccine? And the answer is, I think I will. You know, coronavirus, it's unpredictable in my opinion. Just the other day, we had a 38-year-old healthy person come with the flu. I'm sorry, not the flu, I have the flu in my mind. Came with abdominal pain, diarrhea stuff, ended up having coronavirus. Acutely deteriorated, coded, and sadly enough, they passed within hours of the arrival to the emergency department admission and then subsequently demise of this patient. So that is freaking scary because at least the flu, you can see a trend, you can see a path, you can know that people with comorbidities and who gets sick and who doesn't. But this coronavirus scares the heck out of me because sometimes it's unpredictable. Now, I'm not as scared as I was when this first started months ago. Then it seems like it was 7 to 8% mortality rate. And even then the morbidity rate was so high, people getting intubated and ventilators. And now what I'm seeing, and again, this is my personal opinion, my experience with these patients is that they're not as sick as they've been. For example, I just stepped out of a room, just wearing my regular mask on a patient who was coronavirus positive last month. She has persistent cough, congestion, she's wheezing, she has a new fever. So maybe she has recurrence of the coronavirus. Maybe the coronavirus never went away, or maybe she has a new upper respiratory infection. We don't know. But I wasn't afraid going into that room, and I'm not afraid coming out of that room. Out of all our doctors, only one got sick. I mean, that to me seems bizarre that we're exposed every day. And sure, we're being careful, we're in masks, but we're not being that careful not to like only one doctor get it. Now, out of our nursing staff, a few have got it. Our respiratory techs, a handful have got it. Certainly in the ICU, you see a lot of the staff have had the coronavirus illness because they're close to in and out of the patient's rooms all the time. But for me, 6 months out of this coronavirus pandemic and not even get sick, it just seems very bizarre to me. So I don't think we're gonna get a flu season like we had other years. So I think it's safe to skip it this year for the healthier patient who has no comorbidities and stuff. For the regular patient, maybe that does have the comorbidities, asthma and other diseases, obviously as school teachers. The thing is, you know, we don't want two potential viruses, you know? So if there's a potential vaccine, something that decreases infectivity, the severity of the illness, or for you of getting sick, even if it's not that great, it's still better than zero, is that should you do that? And of course, as a healthcare professional, as somebody who's gonna be giving recommendations whether or not to take the vaccine, I probably are gonna recommend it to most people. And very few that don't wanna take it, I'm not gonna be too harsh on them either. Because personally, I don't think I'll make much difference this year. So anyway, again, these are personal opinions, not recommendations. I'm not encouraging you to do or not to do something. I'm just saying what I feel. Now, if it came down to the hospital saying, oh, well, you really should have it, and here's the shot. Yeah, I'm not gonna not take it if they kind of pin me to the wall, but I'm not gonna go out of my way to get the shot this year. And for my kids, I don't think I'm gonna encourage it either. Now, if they happen to get an appointment, we're at the doctor and they offer it, maybe I'll go ahead and take it then, but I don't think I will force my way through it. I'm not gonna go out of my way to it. I'm just gonna do what we're doing now, washing our hands a lot, wearing our masks in public, you know, being careful, and those kinds of things. So I hope you're staying healthy, you're staying well. Do tell me about your coronavirus stories, about maybe some questions that you have. I will do my best to give you a really good evidence-based answer, my personal opinion. And just because of a doctor, I am a doctor, you don't have to trust my opinion either. We all have opinions and they're just that. And this is mine. So thank you for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it and stay tuned. I will be posting other stuff soon, procedures and things like that to life. So thank you so much for your support. For all of you that were concerned that I had disappeared, I'm still around. So take care.